So here's a nice looking Corvette. This is a convertible. Very nice, clean looking red interior. This is also the first generation that the Stingray came out. This is actually the C2 body style. One of my Facebook friends actually noted that in my previous Corvette video I made here. I accidentally made an arrow, so shout out to him for the correction. So yeah, this is actually the C2 Corvette from 1963 to 1967. And this is also when the 427 big block came around. Get these in a 327 or a 350 or a 427. And a lot of guys, like, they get these, they drag race these. They use them as, like, show cars or whichever. And it also has those little cute knockoff style wheels where you hit them with, like, a little rubber mallet. They come right off. And they make these in a hardtop coupe, which I prefer. Interestingly, there's no mirror on this side, only on the driver's side. That's kind of odd. Definitely would need another mirror for this one. This is actually the C3. This was made from 1968 all the way to 1982. This is the longest running generation of the Corvette. And this is also the Stingray, as you can see here. This comes in also a 327 or a 350, even a 427 as well. This one is also a convertible. And I don't know if these are knockoff rims or what, but those are pretty cool. And this is the third generation of the Corvette. Whereas this is the second generation. So this is the C2, and this is the C3. And this car was featured in an episode of Monster Garage, where Jesse James and his crew turned it into a four-wheel drive mud-bogging racer. They made a custom transfer case for it to power the front wheels, gave it a driving front axle, gave it 35-inch mud-bogging tires, 600 horsepower with nitrous, made it a real monster. And that's what I think about when I see this particular generation of the Corvette. They call that one the Slingray. That's what I think when I see this car. Because, yeah, this could be a pretty good off-road monster if you tune it that way. Same with this one, too. And a lot of these, they could be autocross cars or circuit race cars or drag racers, depending on how you tune them. And they could be custom made as well. But these are all original, as you can see here. No modifications here. But you could turn these into hot rods or whatever you want. So once again, this is the C2 from 1963 to 1967. And this is the C3 from 1968 to 1982. Beautiful looking set of Corvettes here. Definitely very nice pieces of history.